standing over unto the Lord. We are handing over, handing over unto the Lord. We are handing over, handing over unto the Lord. We are handing over, handing over unto Jehovah. We are handing over, handing over unto the Lord. We are handing over, handing over unto the Lord. We are handing over, handing over unto the Lord. We are handing over, handing over unto the Lord. We are handing over, handing over unto the Lord. We are in over, handing over unto the Lord. We are in over, handing over unto the Lord. Unmute your mic and begin to hand over your heart to the Lord Jesus. Hand over your thoughts, hand over your mind, hand over everything that concerns your being. God, our heart is before you tonight. Oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, God, minister to our heart, touch our heart in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, we need divine encounter. We are praying that we encounter your power in the mighty name of Jesus. God, will restore us back, will restore our spiritual life in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for what you are going to do tonight. Mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Spirit of God. We hand over to you.
Hand over to you. Hand over to you. Thank you, Jesus.
The mighty name of Jesus. God, let your will be done. Let your name be glorified in our meeting tonight. Spirit of God. Have your will, O God. Have mercy upon us, O God. The mighty name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, let your name alone be glorified in this meeting. The mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, be our faith with thanksgiving.
Amen.
By the grace of God, tonight we are going to be listening to a message titled "Recover Your Spirituality in Christ" by our mommy in the Lord, Sister Linda. So I want us to pray that God, as I listen to this message, amen, in any area I need that recovery, amen, in any area I am lacking behind, oh God, tonight is a night of recovery. Amen. Father, I pray that you will help me, you will help me to understand those areas I need to work on. In the mighty name of Jesus, open your mouth and begin to ask God. God, Jehovah, we thank you for a blessed Tuesday night, oh God, to be in your presence.
Amen.
My Father, my God, we will not take it for granted because it is not everybody that wants to be here that can be here.
Amen.
But giving us grace to be here, to worship you, to praise you, to be in your presence. Oh Lord, we thank you for this great privilege that you have given to us to be in your presence tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Father, we are bringing this meeting before you, oh God, and we hand over to you, God, the Father. We hand over to you, God, the Son. We hand over to you, God, the Holy Spirit, that you will take preeminent control of everything that will be done here tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. King of glory, any power that wants to interfere, you will strike them by your thunder in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Any power that wants to bring confusion, that wants to bring destruction, that wants to steal your word from the heart of your people, oh God, you will arise and you will scatter them in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I mean, meeting, bend us off from every power of darkness in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I cover this meeting with the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I cover the message you are going to listen to with the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Spirit of God, I pray that you will minister to our heart tonight, that our life will never remain the same. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will revive our spiritual life. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will revive our spiritual life. In the mighty name of Jesus, our prayer life will be revived. In the mighty name of Jesus, our Bible study life will be revived. In the mighty name of Jesus, our evangelism will be revived. That pastoral resource for you will be revived. In the name of Jesus, anything that the devil has killed in our life, oh God, tonight there will be great revival in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we thank you for what you are going to do tonight. In Jesus' name, we have prayed with thanksgiving.
Amen.
He went, he was doing good. Almighty healer, he the leper. When the cripples saw him, they started walking. Anywhere he went, my Lord was doing good. Anywhere he went, he was doing good. Almighty healer, he the when the cripples saw him, they started walking. Anywhere he went, Jesus was doing good. Anywhere he went, he was doing good. Almighty Allah, he the leper, when the cripples saw him, they started walking. Anywhere he went, my God was doing good. Tonight, the Lord God Jehovah will do us good tonight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Spirit of God. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed in amen. I will call on our sister, Sister Rosa. She's going to share the message. Amen. Sister Rosa, go ahead and share the message. God bless you, ma'am.
Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. So I will share my screen. Amen. And I have shared the title of the message in the chat so we could all take it down for a record, or if you wanted to go back and listen to the message again. Amen. And I pray we are all seeing the right screen. Hallelujah. Amen. Yes. Okay, wonderful.
Everlasting Father, we want to thank you for your hour like this. Thank you, Lord, for being in Garrity this hour. Thank you for your daughters that have gathered themselves to recover their spiritual life. Father, we pray.
And sorry, sisters, if you feel like it's low, you have to increase your volume because that's how it's recorded. Amen.
That God, may you speak to them in Jesus' name. May you recover them, O Lord, as they desire to be recovered. In the name of Jesus, let there be revival in Garrity Zone in Jesus' name. Let the children of God that gather in Horemo to serve you in Garrity be recovered in Jesus' name. We thank you for what you are going to do throughout this weekend in Garrity Zone. Tomorrow, your servant will be here. And Sunday, you will be here again with your servant. Father, we want to thank you for all the souls that are going to be won for this program in Jesus' name. Today you are starting with your daughters. I pray that God, may you visit each one of them in Jesus' name. Father, use me, O Lord, to speak to your children. Because the word say your sheep hear your voice and they honor you. Not my own voice. Let your voice be heard and they will honor your word and repent and recover their life in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray every activities of the enemy, witches and wizards, evil powers that have released against this gathering for making people not to believe, surrender to your word. I destroy all their manipulation, all their works in this hall outside by the power in the name of Jesus. I drive every evil contrary spirit out of this place by the authority of the Holy Ghost. I bind them out in the name of Jesus. I arrest all principalities and powers seated here, physical, spiritual, demon. I arrest you by the power of the Holy Ghost. I say, let the Holy Spirit arrest you. Let the power of the Holy Ghost arrest you. Anyone here sent by the devil to manipulate, to do evil, I arrest you by the authority of Jesus. I say, let you be bound in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, loose your children, open their hearts to receive the word. Every hardened heart, whatever Satan has done to their heart, that they will not hear the word. They play with the word, they trust the word. Their unbelief is greater than their faith. Father, I break every unbelieving heart, every hardened heart to righteousness, every power of sin that has swallowed them up. Today is their day of salvation. Father, we destroy every power of sin in their life. In Jesus' name! Many names will be written in the book of life. Many will surrender. Many will recover their lives, their spiritual life. Father, we thank you for this day. I bless all the ones that are here, even the invitees that are here. Thank you for honoring our invitation. May the Lord honor them in Jesus' name. And all the old members of our mother that are here, Father, you will reward them. You will bless them. You will revive them. You will use them greatly in your entire movement in Jesus' name. As we start, Holy Spirit, start with us. Thank you for what you're going to do in advance. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Put your hands together for Jesus. I greet you all in the name of Jesus. I want to thank you for being here today. I'm so grateful for this wonderful invitation. Hallelujah. I'm happy to be in Galilee soon. Today we are going to talk about recovering. Hallelujah. We are going to recover what the devil has stolen from you, or what you have left behind, or what you are looking for, or you have trashed it. You will see in the theme here, they say, recover your spirituality in Christ. Hallelujah. For me, I will now say, back to your roots. Back to your roots. Because in Christ is where we were coming from heaven. All of us were created from heaven. And we're supposed to dwell in Christ. We're supposed to live in Christ throughout our stay on planet Earth before we go back to heaven. But some people will not go back to heaven. Some will be going to hell. If you don't recover your spiritual life now, if you don't recover your spirituality now when you are healthy, you don't do what God said we should do as children of God. Or let me put it general term, Christians, because some people, they will tell you that we are not all born again. Or everybody will say we are born again. But I want to tell you, not all that say, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of God. So you that want to go to heaven, there are criteria, there are things you need to recover, you need to do, you need to practice. You should not get tired of doing those things till you enter heaven. But if you are not sitting down, some of you have been deceived, or I would say you have been carried away by, I know holiness, I dress holy, I know what is holiness, I know hearing can take people to hell. So you are so confident and relaxed that I know holiness. You are not doing your activities as a child of God. And I want to tell you, it will be a shock to you to know that many of you, your spiritual life, one or two ways, have gotten virus. And you don't know, but you are still believing that you will see Jesus. When the rapture will take place, or you will die, it's going to shock many Christians when the Lord will tell them, depart from me. So now that you are alive, I want you today, as we team this topic, this program, recover your spirituality in Christ. That is what we are going to do today. That is what I'm going to say here today. There is a song I listened to, and I like the song. I sang it. I was not able to sing all in the youth conference, but that song is very powerful. It said, that cry you will cry when the saints have gone. Cry it now when the saints are still around. That shout you will shout when the saints have gone. Shout it now when the saints are still around. After rapture, there will be no more mercy. This is the time for you to ask for God's mercy when the saints are still around. And I added my own to it. I said, that cry you will cry when you die and miss heaven. Cry it now while you are still alive, because you will cry. When you die and the Lord say, you are not qualified. Your spiritual life was not perfect. You do some, and the other ones, you have F9. So today, when you will be crying in that hellfire for second chance, all the people in hell, their target, they are saying, God, give me second chance. That second chance that you want to be crying here for second chance, please cry it now here. Please ask God for the grace to do what he's supposed to do to go to heaven. Because today Christians are playing with the grace. You hear many things that is happening in the church. Just as I was coming, I was listening to one video. The pastor is telling people that, come and put money in my hand to bribe my angel, or else he will not have blessing. The church is a market, but many Christians don't know. It's a business place. Many pastors are not called by God. They call themselves. And since they call themselves, their motto is to get money and enrich themselves. And now Christians today in the world don't want where they are telling them the truth. They like where they are pampering them and saying, if we have been talking about grace here, if we are talking about prosperity here, or there's a prophetess coming that will come and tell you what will happen tomorrow, there will be no space here. Because this is what Christians like to hear today. They don't want holiness. Many people, they have not gone to Horimo, but those people, they have had that. In Horimo, they don't tolerate sin, they preach against sin, all this naked dressing. Some people say, I will never be their member. So today, you that you are a member of Horimo, it will be paining you. It will pain you seriously. You know this truth, and then at the end, you end up with them in hell. It's very painful. It's very, very painful. So we go on with our message. I'm going to give you the topic today: recover your spirituality in Christ. I am here to help my brethren in the Lord, my sisters in the Lord, and then we have some brothers in our midst. I want you to recover your spirituality in Christ. When a person is born again, his life is like a seed that is sown in a ground that begins to grow. When you give your life to Christ, it's like a seed. Now it's raining season, people are planting, putting seed. You are expecting it to grow. This is a born-again Christian. The day you give your life to Christ, you are like a seed planted in Christ. And the Lord wants to see you growing. You should not be that baby Christian. What you used to do, you do them again. No. You are now in Christ. You have sown a seed. Jesus is in you now. And you are in Christ now. You are like a seed. The plant is growing physically. When you plant it, like maybe this one is an artificial flower. It is a natural flower. When they put it here, there is soil inside. Everybody in this church expects that this plant that we have put here, we are watering it, it should be growing. So a plant, when you plant something, when you plant a seed, you expect the seed to grow physically. The tree will grow, bear fruit. If it's mango, if it's corn, you are expecting, okay, this corn should have grown. Oh, by 6 months, time, we'll start harvesting our corn, our rice, our beans, things like this, because that's why you plant the seed. So likewise, believers, we grow spiritually. We are like a plant. Plants grow physically, we see, but we grow spiritually. Hallelujah. I told somebody that we are giving our body food. We eat food for we to grow. When you give back to a baby, you give the baby milk, water, things that will make the baby to be growing. Age 1 month, 2 months, you see the baby body is changing. I want you not to forget that the spiritual life, which is our spirit soul, they too, they need food. But the food they need, it is not rice, it is not beans, it is not swallow. What they need is what I'm going to tell you. That's why you see many Christians that have been in church for 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, 15 years, 12 years, 8 years in the Lord. But you see, they always call for counseling in the sense of, I don't know, I fall again. The devil is just attacking me. I don't know. I know that lying is a sin. I don't have power to stop lying. I don't know. When I saw my old boyfriend, I don't know the power to stop him when he was touching me. I just fall. I don't know. This dressing, I know it's bad, but I don't know. Anytime I see makeup, I want to go to... You are behaving like a child. It's because your spiritual man is lame. It's so don't have strength, power to push against sin. Since you give your life to Christ, 2013 to now, you are still struggling with sin. Because your spiritual man is weak. You are not giving the spiritual life in you food. Hallelujah. There are things the plant needs in order to grow strong, produce more fruits. When you plant, you make a farm. Some of you are doing farming now. You go for fertilizer, you look for manure. This, there are major things between it. There are many things, but the most important of those things is one, is water. Many of us, when many people that are doing agriculture, they used to pray for rain. In fact, some people even give us prayer for mommy, please. They should pray that God should send rain, because if there is no water, the plant will not grow. Is it not so? You need water. You want to do agriculture. You want to plant. You want to do something. The first thing you think about, if you're in a desert place, the first thing you think about, how will I get water to be supplying this thing? Or I need to look for a swampy place, because the first thing the plants need to grow is water. That's why it's hard to hear people planting during dry season, unless you have to be doing physical watering. But everybody is waiting for rainy season, because the main thing the plant needs, one of the most important things, is water. Hallelujah. The next thing is sunlight. This sun you are seeing, sometimes it's good for the plant. Then you have the next thing is nutrients, like we call it manure, fertilizer, everything. You see people go there with thinking cow dung, all these fall sheets, they go to poultry. These are things for we. You say, what is this? How can you carry sheets to your garden? But the plants need it. It grows. It grows the plant very well. And the other thing is weeding. Weeding the grass. If you don't go to your farm more than 2-3 months, when you come, the grass have covered the granite. And sometimes they choke the plants not to grow. Is it not so? So you see some people will be telling somebody, let me go and check my farm. I've left my house for more than 2 months and I planted a corn and I plant a granite. I know these children, if they don't go and weed grass, it's just in vain. You know, weeding the grass is part of agriculture work. So also, the believers need the following to grow spiritually strong. A believer needs this thing I'm going to say. Please, I'm expecting you to write it down. Because you are going to be praying about it. God, I need these things in my life to grow spiritually. A believer needs the following to grow spiritually strong. Hallelujah. The first thing a believer needs, that when you give your life to Christ, or you say, I am a believer, the first thing you need, and you need this thing till you die or till rapture, it will not depart from you, the first thing is the word of God. This word should not depart from you. That is what God told Joshua. If you want to do my work as Moses was doing it, this word, Joshua, reading it every day, meditate on it, it should not depart from you. So as a believer, this word should not depart from you. We are going to take 5 points before we go into it. The second one is prayer. Prayer. The Bible makes it clear that prayer is the key. When you have the key, you open the gate of heaven and enter. Hallelujah. If you are a believer, you don't pray. You call yourself Christian. That's why many Christians, they are in hell. Because they don't hear from God. They don't have discerning spirits. They don't know when God is speaking. They don't know when God is teaching them, training them. Everything is on pastor. They will sit 5 hours waiting for a man of God to pray 10 minutes prayer over their life. They are so lazy, they don't pray. It's when you pray, the Lord will speak to you. It is not magic. Some of us that hear from God, you think that we are special people that God does too. Yes, you will say like that, but I want to tell you that there is no barrier between you and God. What sister that you will hear from God? If you two sitting there, you pray, when I will say it, you say, me to God, say it to me, because you are a child of God, you pray. Before you go to a pastor, I want to know what is the mind of God. If you pray, you have time with God, the Lord will tell you. You will only go for confirmation to know, is it not Satan deceiving me? But many of you don't pray. And you say you want to go to heaven. I'm sorry for you. Heaven is far away from me, because the Bible makes it to know that we wrestle against principalities and power. Not physical people, it's spiritual people. And the only weapon for you to disarm a spirit, to oppress a spirit, to fall, to stop fighting you, is through prayer. So if you're a believer, you don't like prayer, you are so lazy, you cannot pray, I pity you, your heaven is hard. You have K-leg. The third one is fellowship with the brethren. Fellowshipping with the brethren. Some of you see today we are here, there are some members that are all remote members that are not here. They are not here. Satan has killed their love of fellowship. They see fellowship as a burden, as a hard work. I beg all the time, all remote have program, all the time we should go for this. I'm tired. I beg. They see the fellowship of the brethren as a burden. Some don't like going to church. They prefer sitting in the house watching Man Zion and say, Man Zion is teaching me. I'm learning more things than being in the church. You are not serious. So, fellowshipping with the brethren. Then, number four is Christian service and activities. Christian service and activities. Mommy Senator here was talking about the commitment of women, what they need to do, what they need to do. This one you will say, this one I'm going to say, as a Christian, there are things you need to do. Play your own part. Don't say they did not call me. Don't say, me, nobody know me in the church. No, there are gifts in you that God has deposited in all human beings. We have different talents that we need to come together to push the work of God. For some of you, you are sitting on talent. Some people, they are good in visitation. They know how to visit members that don't want to come to church that have been discouraged. God has put a word in your mouth where you visit them, talk to them, encourage them. You will see them start coming. There are some people, they know how to evangelize. Evangelism team have been going their fruit. But there are some people that God has given them gifts when they go out, they bring people. So there are things you need to do to service the house of God. Activities you need to play to do the things of God. Then lastly, leadership correction, advice, and supervision. Hallelujah. We have leaders. We have chapter leader, unit leader, prayer warrior, women leader, youth leader. Even in your own place, you have leaders for different things. Kitchen, somebody that is the head of media, head of usher, head of choir, head of, these are leaders. Maybe you have women leader, unit women leader, you have evangelism leader, you have, different leaders in the church. So it's very important for we to know how to relate with our leaders, because some of you, your behavior towards your leaders have disqualified you going to heaven. So leadership correction, advice, and supervision is necessary for we to recover, for you to recover your spirituality in Christ. Hallelujah. Number one, we go with the word of God. 1 Peter chapter 2. 1 Peter chapter 2. What is the word? Why we need the word? 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 2 says, as newborn babies desire the sincere, not the fake milk. Any child that is born, what the child needs and what the doctor will tell, the best milk, is it not the breast milk? Is the breast milk. Not this cow milk, not this goat milk, not these other ones. They are necessary, but the sincere milk is this breast milk. Because they say there are many nutrients in this breast milk. Is it not so? So the Bible is trying to tell us that, because many people today, you just depend on prophecy. You don't want the word of God. You just depend on revelation. You don't want the word of God. You just depend on, I'm going to this prophet. I am going to bet myself in this church. That is what, these are milk that are not sincere. The sincere milk that you need to grow is this word. Any church that you go, they take 5 hours, 2 hours, is prophecy, dancing. The word is not preached to you well. I say that place is not a sincere need they are sharing there. You will not grow well. You will grow kwashioko, big stomach, big head. And you will not be able to run and wrestle with the devil in the time of coming to God. As newborn babies desire the sincere milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby. This word, it's for you to grow. It's for you to start seeing the vision of God. It's for you want discerning spirit is from this word. You want to hear how God speak to people. Study the word. How do people see vision? Study the word. How is somebody able to detect witches around? Study the word. How is somebody able to preach very well, knowing the scripture? Like when Daddy Rika is preaching, quoting scripture, people say, wow, this man no have no Bible, and he's opening Bible for us. Because you hear his testimony since he was a youth, since he as a young child, he has given himself to the world. So if you as a believer that really want to make heaven, you are from different denomination. You are not a Orimo member only. I'm not talking to only Orimo member. I'm talking to Christians all over the world, that all Christians, our motto, our desire is to make heaven. If you really want to go to heaven and do not want to miss heaven, this world is what you need. Study the word of God. Study it very well. find it where they teach it very well, where you can get it, the raw true word of God. Not this fake word of God that fooled the whole world today. Fake pastors, fake prophetess, fake prophets, fake reverend, fake bishop. No. That's why you be under there for 10 years, 15 years. You cannot live sin. You know that you cannot stop sin. That's why your mind has now said that nobody can be righteous. Some of us will be under pastors for how many years? We can lie. We fight in the church. We do fornication. We'll be hearing that these things are sinful. We sit and say, when will I stop this fornication? God, when will I stop this anger? When will I stop this? Because we were not getting a sincere word. The power in their mouth from pastors, the word in their mouth is defiled. It's not sincere. So you have to desire the sincere milk so that you can grow in the Lord to overcome satanic temptation. You need to get the sincere word. As a sincere child of God, you need the word of God. You need the word of God. Where can you find this word? One, the Bible, as we say. You find the word of God in the Bible. You find the word through listening to preaching. Sometimes people say, I did not go to school. I don't know how to read. There is no excuse. But the Bible has told that there is no excuse before God for you to say, God, I didn't go to school. That's why I was not reading your word. That's why I don't know anything about you. No. But you have ears. You can hear. Their language, their good preaching in your language. Good preaching in Pidgin. Good preaching in English. At least you can hear it if you cannot read the word. So you can get the word of God through preaching. This assignment they are giving us in Horemo. Many of you in women conference, past women conference, you cannot come out to take book because you don't have time. Satan has taken the time to sit down to read, looking for money. Phone has distracted us. Money has distracted us. Job has distracted us. And you will be the one crying attack. You'll be the one to say you want to go to heaven. You cannot make this heaven if you don't feed your spirit with this word. If you don't have time for the word. If you don't have time to hear the messages of God. I do not go to school. It's not the answer before God. You think you can use that to God will say, okay, enter. No. If you cannot read, you don't have time to read the books now. That's why God has given wisdom to the church. So even go to the point to do audio messages, audio books. Even the Bible now is in audio. Is it also? You play it, the original Genesis chapter 1. In the beginning, you will pause it when you feel to sleep. When you wake up, you start again, you will hear, and it's going according to that reading the book. So you can feel yourself with it. You don't read Bible. Some people, they cannot, that's why you can't evangelize, because when somebody asks you a question, where is it the Bible that hearing is a sin? You don't know. You say, well, we in our church, they say hearing is a sin. That's why I'm telling you, hearing is a sin. Madam, you want me to remove my hearing? Show me in the Bible. You are so shameful. You cannot show the person because you don't have time for the word. Some of you only open Bible chapter meeting time, Bible study time, or conference, or when you go to church on Sunday. After then, when you come home, no time to study the Bible. Personal devotion, you don't have time. Devotion in the house, you don't open Bible. You don't have time to read your Bible. And you say you want to win, so you say you want to work for God. You say you want to fight the devil. You say you want to overcome Satan. When the devil came to tempt Jesus, he come through by the word. And Jesus used the word to overcome him. But some of you, you call yourself leader in the church, have been in holiness for how many years? You don't know more than 5 scriptures off air. You cannot quote it off air. So check yourself. Are you qualified? In Jesus coming, are you qualified to brag and stand and say, I am a child of God? I know the word. The word dwelleth in me. Are you qualified? Do you know God? How will you know God? That's why you sin always. You say, oh, I didn't know it was a sin. Sister, this thing you are doing, but hey, I didn't know. How will you know? You don't read the book. You don't have time for the Bible. You don't listen to messages that will teach you what is right, what is wrong. God has given us pastors in this movement that they will teach us. When you hear one, sometimes you are very angry. Sometimes you don't know what to do. Only one message you will listen from this movement. Many people have testified of it. Say, when I listen to daddy message, when I listen to this coordinator message, when I listen to this woman leader message, actually the person was talking to me direct. And I was in that position of that problem. And now I know what to do. If that person would not have listened to that message, anger would have carried her, temptation, Satan would have counseled her in evil. So please, you can find the word through listening to messages. Through devotional books. Devotional book. In the movement here, we have devotional book. If you want to get the word of God that will build up your spiritual life, please try to get your devotional book and make sure you follow it. Even if you were not able to do study it in the morning, you are running somewhere, make sure that in the night before going to bed, read what the devotional is saying today, what we should do, what we should know. But how many of you here that have thrown devotional book away? You don't have time to read it. You only hear testimony from people. Oh, today the devotional topic is saying, you'll be looking at it, they say, what did they say? You don't know. I want to tell you, Satan has slowly carried you, your spiritual life away from you. If you are not doing these things, you are not spiritual. You are like a perfume that have finished in the bottle, but the scent is just there. You are empty. You are just dressing holy, but inside is empty. Satan is just laughing at you. You don't read, you don't do devotion with your family. You don't read devotional. You don't listen to messages. You don't read your Bible. Yeah, are you a Christian? A mouthy Christian. You only talk in your mouth. I'm a Christian. This thing is evil. How will you know? Then the next step is through listening to messages, DVDs, CDs, memory card, even your phone, you can get messages from your phone. YouTube, media can do it for you. How many of you, your phone is loaded with messages? Even when they put the messages on your phone, how many of you have time to listen to it? You will go and meet media. Please put for me 100 messages. Since they put it, you only listen to 2 messages. You don't have time. You burn the battery after charging your phone. The first thing you will do is WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, this thing, calling. No time. You will not say my battery run down because I listened to 4 messages, 2 messages. How do you want to make heaven? God has given us all the provision. Some of you say, I don't have DVD, but you have phone. I want you to sit down to see that because the Bible said there is not going to be any excuse for any human being why you miss heaven. If you want to say, God, in my house, we don't have money to buy DVD. In fact, satellite we don't have. God will say, but you were having phone. And your phone was having a memory card. What is full in your memory card? Pictures. Selfie. You are snapping the beach. You snap in the church. Wedding. Show your daily. Hey, what were you there? That is what filled your phone. What will you tell God? You have lost your spiritual life. Today, you must recover those things. These things I'm telling you, you must recover them back because Satan have made you to hate. You see that it's burden. Ah, that the recovery is too long. Me, I'm not able to listen to message. I'm tired. You are beginning to look for short messages. That is one of the ways Satan used to kill us. He will kill our spiritual activities. What we need to do every day. As you wake up in the morning, you think of breakfast because your body need food. If you don't give the body food, ulcer will box you. You forget about your spiritual man, that he too need food. What is the food? Pray in the morning, study the Bible, have quiet time with God, feel it. Then you know that, oh, today I pray for 45 minutes, 1 hour. Ah, today I read 2 chapters. Oh, today I have quiet time with the Lord. The Lord spoke to me. Oh, the spiritual man too is happy. Ah, I've eaten this morning. In the evening, too, before you go to bed, as you are thinking of taking lunch or dinner, think of the spiritual man to take lunch and dinner. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But some of us, we only think about the physical body to take lunch, dinner, and breakfast. We don't think about spiritual man need breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Sometimes we only give the spiritual man breakfast. If you pray in the morning, you don't pray again till the other day. And the spiritual man is getting lean, dying, getting dry. That's why you will not make heaven. That's why you will not make heaven. Mommy Jamla was telling us about nutrients we need in the body. If you don't have this balanced diet in your body, when you fall sick, little malaria, that's why you hear some people, they are just walking, they buck their leg, they fall down and die. Because the sickness comes into them, they don't know, and fight all the cells. The cells were weak. You were not feeding them well. You were malnourished. This is how Christians, only one attack a witch, we attack a believer. A believer, though, yes, the believer have died. Why? And you hear a witch will be saying that, I kill him, I kill her. Why? Before that believer was just carried away by my blessing, I'm a holiness member, you are just dragging. The thing that will protect you from these wicked people in our midst, you are not doing it. You don't pray. You don't read the word of God. You don't listen to our messages. You don't build your spiritual life. So from today, for you to get your spirit, to recover your spirituality in Christ, make sure the word of God do not depart from you. Turn to John chapter 8. Make sure this word to dwell in your mouth always. John chapter 8. John chapter 8, read verse 30 to 32. He said, and he spake these words. Many believe on him. Then said Jesus to those Jews which believe on him, if ye continue in my word, then are ye my disciples indeed. If you continue in this word, continue studying the word of God, continue listening to holy messages, continue reading the word of God, I'm telling you, you are truly a child of God. Anywhere you go, people will know. You don't even need to tell somebody that I'm a child of God. Somebody will walk up to you and say, the Lord has told me that you are his daughter. You are his son. Because Christ dwells in you. You are filled with the word. Temptation, all this thing that people are living on the mall will go to your house and say, have you had? Live on the mall. It's like this. This Alina is like this. Are you to say, it's like that? And you follow it because you are weak, you are baby. If you're a child of God, you even cancel those that come to remove you because you will be with the world. You will now tell them what a Christian to do, how a Christian to tarry their cases to God, not in the internet, not in the Facebook, not by fighting. You, as you be with the word of God, you will correct those backsliders. But because you too, you are weak in the world, somebody will come and meet you and tell you black and blue, you do take your bag and rest. I leave the house of God that you have the word that will change you. So you are not a true disciple. See what Jesus said, verse 32, he said, and ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. You can never be free if you don't know the word of God. But when you know the word of God, you will be free. We have been busy praying for other Christians in different denominations. Why? Because they don't know the truth. Those days, as a sinner, in my simple life, what I am preaching now, the way I'm dressing now, they have told me since how many years back by my younger sister with my elder brother. They will sat me down, Linda, because why? They will see that I will be betting very fast. Where are you going? If it is the rain is coming, we have prayer meeting in the church. I have to go and sing. I will sit down, the composing song, because I was in a choir. You know, we have to compose song. Next Sunday we have Thanksgiving, we have to bring songs. The choir master says, everybody go and compose. This is the team, bring song. We'll sit down. You will see me at night. I will be singing. Oh, this one don't match. This one. I'll think that record my voice. So she saw that I love service in the house of God. Hey, my pastor says he's traveling and we should buy his ticket. He will say, I want to shopping. The women will take over my shopping. The youth will take over part of my ticket. These are the money in the church. And all of us will say, we need to sow into Papa's life as he's going to abroad. You will see me cracking my brain. What will I need to give now? What will I need to sell now to pay so that I will pay my own due in the church? So my elder brother and my younger sister noticed that I love God. I support children of a pastor. I will die going to church, everything. They now bring me and say, come. You have not known the truth. All this work you are working, thinking that God will bless you. He will bless you, but heaven, you will not go. When they used to tell me that, it will pain me in my heart. I said, what do you mean, Linda? What do you mean, brother? Do you know I'm suffering in the church? Who will sing in the church, sweep the church, clean the church, give pastor, even when we don't have, we'll give pastor. Dance under rain, doing revival, we'll give flyers to people, come to our church, even if rain is coming, we'll be dancing, playing speaker, we'll be giving people out like this. And with all these service, you know, people are telling me I will not go to heaven if I die, God don't know me. It was because I lacked the truth. Many of you, you call yourself Christian, you are not closer to heaven because you lack the truth. So many Christians in the church, they don't read the Bible, they don't know the Bible, their pastors is their Bible. They lack the truth. The truth that will make them to be set free from oppression, from late marriage, from barrenness, from anger, from things they even then they will tell that I know smoking is a sin, but I don't know how to stop it. You see a zealous brother in the house of God, bro. Don't you know that fornication is a sin? Yes, I know, but I don't know how to stop it. How will you know? Because you lack the truth. The church where you are don't have the truth for you. When they were telling us that attachment, earrings, short skirt, naked dressing, boyfriend, smoking, parties, and see, it was paining me. Why? Because I lack the truth. But since I have my encounter with Christ, 2013, this one, it is not that somebody appeared to me. It was me, myself. God took me to go and see where sinners we end. And when I came back, the truth set me free. Is it also? When you have the truth, you are set free today from all this worldliness, the pressure of the world, every fashion you need. You don't have money for trousers. You are thinking of sleeping with three men. Now today, children of God in Horimo, we are set free from all this worldly pressure. Hey, new we want to come out, I need it. Oh, this new car, I need it. Oh, this new fashion, I need it. Everything is worriness because we know it by the truth. So if you don't know the word, you will lack the truth, and that truth will not set you free. It's only when you know the truth that will set you free. All these things you are doing in churches, you are doing as a Christian, you smoke, you fornicate, you disrespect your husband have girlfriend, you two have boyfriend, you do like this, you say you're a Christian, you lack the truth. You will not go to heaven. Your spiritual life has been hijacked. Your spirituality has been hijacked. So today you need to recover your spiritual life in Christ, or else no heaven. No heaven for you. That is what the Bible has said. For we to be a true Christian, a true disciple of Jesus, the word should not depart from us. And when we know the word, we will not depart from the word of God. Hallelujah. The second one is prayer. As I say, prayer. Prayer is the key. Prayer is talking to God, opening your mouth to say something to God. It's just like now, I want to talk to my husband. It's not at all. What do you used to do? Call him on phone. I want to speak to my children. I don't know where they are. They are not in the house. What you do? Call them on phone. Will you sit in your house and say, oh, where is my children now? They will hear. You have to do something. Praying is when you are talking to God. It's like, I want to go and talk to God. You talk to God through prayer. God reply you. You will see some people when they are praying say, the Lord has given me peace in my mind that I should go ahead with this thing. This is where you need prayer. But many Christians, Satan have hijacked prayer from their life. And I'm telling you, they will not go to heaven. They will not go to heaven. One of the things Jesus was rebuking the disciples for, can't you watch with me only 1 hour? Peter, pray, because Satan has desired to save you. But what did he say? He didn't say, but I have talked to God. He said, I have prayed for you. It's through prayer that God, Jesus made for Peter. That prayer answered in heaven, and God released power for Peter. When he fall, he will rise. So you as a child of God, if you are not praying for your children, you are not praying for your husband, you are not praying for the church that the devil should not attack the church, you are not praying for your spiritual life, you are balanced. This world is not our home. You think you are in heaven. This world is not our home. You will die one day. It's now you need to prepare your way to heaven. You don't pray. You wake up in the morning. You just rub anointing oil, lick it, and say you are covered. I pity many Christians. As holiness member, you wake up in the morning. You are running. Hey, I'm late. You don't have time to pray. When you come back, you enter straight in the kitchen. You cook. Late to pray, you start sleeping. Father Lord. Tomorrow again, the same routine. Are you not tired of your dryness? Are you not tired of that life? Every time, confession in the unit, confession in the chapter. When did you people gather and say, today, that witch or wizard, that demon that is bringing confusion that we are not growing, we busy people in evangelism all the time, we are not seeing fruit. All the time, we are not seeing breakthrough in our unit. You people don't pray, but you murmur, gossip, coordinated like this, unit leader is like this. They murmur 5 hours, 3 hours, but no prayer. Women don't pray. We call turning point. How many of you were here? As long as the year is night vision. Because you like that time by 1, 2, you are enjoying your sleep. Me, I will never go turning point this year or it's next year. It's only God that will know if you will see next year. When they call for prayer, chapter is calling for prayer, unit is calling for prayer, state is calling for prayer, zone is calling for prayer, you will see 3, 4 people will come. Some way you ask that sister, we did not see for bed. My son was running temperature. And that day I forgot I went to market, I did not close it. I went to the bank delayed me. Please excuse. All these things you busy keeping yourself with. When you die, you leave the bank, you leave the children. You don't even bother to say, who will take care of my child? You will not die and leave them. If they die, they die. And the thing that will save you before God is prayer, but you don't have time for prayer now. You don't have time with God. Prayer is a time you converse with God. It's just like when your husband and wife, you say, it's later, let me go into the room so that me and my husband will talk. Prayer is the time you talk with God. It's the time you rub skin with God. It's the time you laugh with God. Sometimes you see you are praying, you laugh because it's like you are feeling sweet presence of God. Sometimes you will be praying, you see some people are smiling. You say, why is this person smiling? You say, don't worry. Because you know how your spirit man is receiving, how God is communicating to you. Sometimes when you are praying, the Lord will say, I like what you are doing. I'm blessed. I'm happy. Go and tell my people this. Tell them this. You get revelation through prayer. But you call yourself a sister. You are not praying. You hate prayer in the house when they say prayer. Immediately they say, let us start praying. The demon of sleep will just come and embrace you. And you, for you to say, no, this life, this kind of thing is something else. Just now when we were busy talking, I was not feeling sleepy. But when they say, let us pray, sleep from nowhere. And for you to get, I told somebody this conference, the youth came to me, that, mommy, when you're talking about masturbation, I'm the one doing that, but I have pray, I don't know what to do. I said, when you used to pray, you used to sleep. He said, mommy, I don't know again. You need them, I need that to pray, I'll just sleep. How long? He said, mommy, it's like that. I said, but when you want to eat, if you sleep, what will you do? He said, mommy, I will shake myself. Which kind of sleep is this? I want to eat. I said, well, that is how you have to do to pray. When you want to watch a movie, when you sleep, you see, you stand up and they look, this, I must finish this movie. When you want to pray, sleep, come, get up, be walking like mad person, up and down. Time yourself, I will pray 1 hour. What stop you to get up? But some of you, when they sleep, embrace you, you will sit there and be sleepy and say, God, understand, I'm tired. Satan is laughing at you because he has taken one of your weapons, the main weapon, which is prayer. Today when you pray, you say you pray 30 minutes, just 30 minutes or when you start praying, 10 minutes sleep, you will now say, okay, in the evening I'll continue. Just 30 minutes. Some people cannot finish a day 30 minutes prayer. Is it not true? There are some people in this movement, 30 minute prayer, they will not finish it in a day. They will postpone it the other day. What about us that are 1 hour? If you can postpone 30 minutes, your spiritual life has been adjusted. Recover your spirituality in Christ now that you are alive. And it's not today, tomorrow. Today, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Open to the book of Philippians chapter 4. If you don't recover your spiritual life, my sister, you will be seeing people rapturing from all the more going, new members that will just join with zeal. You will say, that's my neighbor. Why me? Because you are lazy. Philippians chapter 4, from verse 6 and 7. Be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. You want money. You want to marry. You want your husband to love you. You want your husband to leave that girlfriend. You want job. You want your children to have job. As a young lady, you are tired of sleeping, with men. You want to marry. As a woman, you want to look presentable to your husband so that his eyes will not go to the street. All what you need is prayer. You want to make heaven. Truly, what these people are saying is true, but I don't know how to come out of this worldly life. It's prayer. Oh, I'm having spiritual attack. Anytime I close my eyes, demonic attack, they are oppressing me. They want to kill me in my office. This that is prayer. Somebody have sent me text that this year will not pass, they will kill me. And fear, you now begin to go from one prophet house to another. What are you going there for prayer? You yourself can pray that prayer. But you are too lazy. You are too weak. So if you don't have prayer, if you don't have prayer life, if you don't have a good prayer life, I'm telling you, you will not make heaven. It will be hard for you. Because it's through prayer you bring your supplication, your problem, your request to God. God, give me victory to make heaven. Father, any power that is holding me not to be holy, not to be righteous, not to stop sin, I destroy those power today in the name of Jesus. You will see those power will leave you. You yourself will testify, those days I can lie. But now, I'm telling you, when somebody asks me a question, I fear to even say, I say the truth. I'm very bold to say the truth because you have gotten power to break that spirit of lie. But some of you don't pray. That's why you still lie. Up to today, you are still lying. And you say you're a believer. You're not a believer. You are not born again. Stop giving Christianity bad name. You call yourself a believer in that office. When they talk about stealing, it's you. You stole that money. You are corrupt in that office. And you say you're a Christian. Don't say like that. You are not. You have to get your spiritual life again as a believer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then he says in verse 7, and the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your heart and mind through Christ Jesus. Your heart, your mind that will bring pollution. The Bible says the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. You want to lie, you start thinking it from your mind, your heart will plan it. Hey, I am going to my boss now. The lie I'm going to give the boss. Let me think which lie I'm going to give this boss now. From inside. So when you are praying, putting your problem to God, the peace of God that passes all understanding will come to you. The first thing he will say, shall keep your hearts and your mind through Jesus Christ. When Christ reigns in you, you don't lie. You don't steal, you don't fornicate, you don't commit adultery, even if your husband is not touching you, your husband has girlfriend. You will not say, me too, I'm going to find my old boyfriend. Your mind will not go there. You will be thinking maturely. You will not think like a baby. Somebody, your neighbor insults me, me too, today I'll tell my neighbor to me too, I'm rude. Your mind will not go there. Somebody match you and say, me too, I will do. You don't do revenge because your mind is full of Christ, heavenly thinking. You think like Christ. You don't think wickedly. But many of you today, as you are sitting here, you call yourself member of holiness. You call yourself a holy sister. You call yourself Christian. You full of revenge. Do me, I do you. This sister, I greet her in the church. You know, I will never greet her again. A believer don't talk like that. This coordinator, he judge my matter and he punish me. You will see in this unit. A believer don't think like that. My husband, I touch him. He tell me I'm busy. Leave me, I'm tired. He will never touch me again. A believer don't think like that. But why are you thinking like that? Because your spirituality is low. Your spiritual man is weak. It cannot revive. It cannot resist sin. That's what I'm telling you. Recover this thing so that your spiritual life will be strong. Or rapture take place, you will not make heaven. The thing you will hear from God's mouth is, depart from me, you walk out for iniquity. Because you hide under holiness dressing, but your attitude is bad. You gossip. You gossip. Even when you were a sinner, you don't gossip the way you gossip now. You gossip. You backbite. Somebody that did not come for chapter meeting, the person is in the house, have known what they discuss. So you take Okada, my sister, thank God you did not go to church today. Today, this and this and this. Why are you doing this? And you say you want to go to heaven? Recover your spirituality before it's too late. Recover your spiritual life. Let others see Jesus in you. When they are talking about holy people in the church, they say, sister, this, who can we give our money to keep? We don't even need to open our account. Call mommy this. You trust her. This woman is holy. Even in the meeting, this woman will not bias anybody. He will give it to you as it is. He don't hide anything. Even to our friend, to our children, she will stand up and tell her, you are wrong. My sister, let's say the truth. Pastor, with all due respect, this thing you said was like that. These are righteous people, God-fearing people. But how many of you today sitting here in Gariki that you are defending the church, defending the movement that have saved you? How many of you today are speaking good about this movement? I told some people, many of the more members that have left and they're talking bad about this movement, only the sin alone, ungratefulness will take them to hell. Because today, for even them to say we know holiness, they learn it from where? From all the more. So that alone will make you to be grateful to this ministry, than to castigate this ministry. Be careful with your words. Waste your time on things that will benefit your life. Don't waste your time listening to things that will not benefit your life. Hallelujah. So please, as the Bible has told, let's turn to Jeremiah chapter 29. Prayer is the key. If you don't like prayer, start liking prayer today. Prayer will save you. Prayer will save you from all temptation. Somebody is coming to tempt you. Somebody is coming to deceive you. You will just hear the Lord say, go into prayer now. There is temptation ahead. We have had many people say, we were in a journey, and then I heard the voice say, pray now. How many of you have had a testimony? Even some of you, things like this have happened in your life. You will be in a journey, and you hear the voice say, pray. The voice did not say, jump. The voice did not say, tell the devil to stop. Run now. There's going to be an accident. Is it like that? What the voice will say, pray now. My son, start praying. Pray against accidents. Because it's only prayer that will stop the evil force not to attack you. Because when the demon of blood, that demon of accident release, you will not see you. You are inside the car going, your head is shaking. But in the spirit realm, Satan has come ahead to block you. And it's only prayer that God will release spirit angels to come and fight them. That's why it's when you pray, something happens in the spirit realm. But if you don't like prayer, I pity you. You keep going from one pastor to another. And this is how they will be laying satanic hand on you. This pastor have one demon. He will give you one. You go to prophet this. He has his own sin. He will add to you. That's why you pray, pray, pray. So sin. No change. You are still a prostitute. You are still following men. Men are still sleeping with you, dumping you. Your husband is still not liking you. You are busy going from one place to another. Anger is still in you. Everywhere you go, mouth is following you. Everywhere they know you as a gossip. But this sister can lie. People have known you. Your life is not good because you don't pray. Invite prayer today. Copy the life of prayer today. You will see testimony in your life in Jesus' name. Jeremiah 29, verse 11. 11 to 13, it says, for I know the thoughts that I think towards you, said the Lord. Thought of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. That is what the Lord has for you. Don't fear God in the sense of, I fear to go to the presence of God. Always like going to the presence of God because his thoughts towards you is not to kill you. Hey, I've committed sin. If I go now before God, Satan will tell you, don't bother to go and pray. God will not answer you. You're a sinner. It's a lie. Go before God in prayer. As a sinner like that, learn to pray. The Lord thought towards you is good and not evil. Then shall ye call upon me, and ye shall go and pray unto me, and I will ask him unto you. You shall go and pray. Come to me. My thought for you is good. No fear. Come to my house. Come and pray. Anytime they call chapter meeting prayer, please learn to be there. Some of you cannot pray alone. Anytime they say prayer, go. Because when others are praying, you are motivated to pray. Before you think 2 hours you are praying, say, in my house, I can't pray like this. That's why when they call units prayer, go. Night meeting, you are there. Don't say, I like sleeping the night. Kill that thought. Come. Zona meeting program, come. Come to pray. Don't get tired. Hallelujah. Because the Lord wants you to ask. He said, then shall ye call upon me, and ye shall go and pray unto me, and I will ask him unto you. Verse 13. And ye shall seek me and find me when ye shall shout for me. Hallelujah. You have to shout for the Lord. If you think that God have to come to your house, it is not like that. You shout for the Lord. How can you do this? It's through prayer. You shall seek the Lord. Meditate. God, I want to feel your presence here. Jesus, I'm in your house. I don't want to go empty. God, visit me. God, come to me. God, speak to me. Jesus, I've come. God, I've come to your presence. Lord, I've come to your presence. As you keep on saying like this, you feel your body, your heart, heavy heart, your anger. You came in. You are very angry. Somebody provoked you. God, take over my heart. I don't want to be angry. God, take over my heart. Jesus, take over my heart. 5 minutes, you are taking over the heart. You will see that anger that you were thinking of tearing somebody will just be peaceful. The matter, you will just laugh over yourself. I'm forgiving that person. I'm not angry again. Because you carry your heart to God. But if you don't pray, little thing, you are fled up. Some of you, they fear to talk to you in the chapter. Hey, that sister, don't talk to her. She will malice you. In fact, she will scatter. She don't fear anybody. People fear to correct you. And how can we not correct you? We have seen evil in you. But because now we are afraid of your anger, of your malice, of your throwback word, you will die in sin. And we, God, have made us to see it in you. So learn to pray. Hallelujah. The next thing is fellowship with the brethren. Learn to fellowship with the brethren. Hallelujah. If you don't learn to fellowship with the brethren, then you will not have the unity of the brethren. You will not have the support, the help of the brethren. What you cannot do alone in your house, like what we are talking about, prayer. Some of you are alone in your house. Some of you are with your children or your unbelieving husband or wife. They can't pray long. When you want to pray, say, I beg, this is your long prayer. But you want to pray, but you know that if you pray alone, it's a problem. Some of you want to listen to messages, but your spouse is not giving you the freedom to listen well. That's why I like to come among the brethren. Go for meeting, chapter meeting, unit meeting, evangelism hour, all these things. Learn to fellowship with the brethren. Don't just be a conference member. Some of you will only see your face when there is conference. Chapter meeting, you don't come. In the chapter, they'll say, Mommy, which sister are you asking for? What sister now in Ghana? Keep having that. The mother don't know how. Oh, that sister, she used to go once in the while. Why is it like that? And when they ask you, they need to say, my head, my teeth, I went to the village, my mother died, my auntie sick, my uncle was dead, he have risen again. Every time, excuse. You don't come to church. You don't come for chapter meeting. Bible study, you don't come. You'll be hearing testimony, say, eh? You don't hear? Somebody was mad. In this youth conference, you hear the testimony. Somebody was mad. As he was hearing, they were praying that the vicar message, he was standing there. The Spirit of God came into him and drove the demon away. The man gave his life to Jesus and he started talking. The family member was happy. Life, they testified. For some youths that don't go for the conference, they will be like, I wish I should have gone. Why you did not go? Because you don't like the presence of God. My job, my organ, they say, who is your organ? Jesus will be your organ. If you know you have a hardy organ that don't want you to be going for work of God, carry that over to God. Who is bigger than God? Who have the power to stop you not to go to the house of God? But it's because you too, you don't like the house of God. You like party. You like marriage. You like this. Some of you, you skip chapter meeting 1 month because we have married. My cousin is getting married. After cousin, the next is my auntie. After auntie, the next is my stepsister, stepbrother. This is all throughout that month you are occupied. And you think you are doing yourself well. You don't have time for God, but when you die, it's God you'll be shouting, Jesus, save me. He too will not hear you when you die in sin. So learn to fellowship. Hebrews chapter 10. Learn to fellowship. Hallelujah. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 25. Not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together, as the manner of some is, but exhorting one another, and so much them more, and ye see the day approaching. Learn to come to the assembly together. Come together. Pray together. Seek that. Don't fear. Say, witches are in the unit too much. I will not go for chapter meeting. Then you are not born again. A child of God don't fear where witches are. Is it not so? because the Bible says, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. It is a witch that should say, me, I'm not, sister, this is coming. Come, me, I'm not going to that lady. Anytime you open her mouth to pray, this is how you see me sign fire. We that are witches, we used to be suffocated. We are not going. But you see a brother, a sister, you say you are born again. I am holy, sanctified. Brother, why are you not coming again? Ah, the last time I go there, shoot me with arrow. I'm not going there again. Oh. You are forsaking the brethren. You are not born again. You are fearing witch. You are fearing wizard. Then you are not born again. Then you are not serious. Then your spiritual life is dry. Then your heaven going is slow. Satan is laughing at you. Just one witch shoot you weapon. You are running away. Just a little attack. Don't you know that you will have attacks like that? Because you wrestle. Satan is fighting you not to enter heaven. Going to heaven is a race. It's a running race. Satan will be throwing something to fall you. He will be defeating you. You must jump. He will throw himself to you. He must swim you away until you finish the finish line. Then you will see Satan will say, ah, this one you have gone. But you, little push, you fall that you get up, you say, I'm going home. You forsake the assembly of the brethren. You are not serious. Start coming back to chapter meeting. Unit meeting, night meeting, women meeting, anything they call, you know that you are supposed to be there. Be there. Be there. Many people say, ah, you now your house be church. Yes, your house will be the church. That is the thing. Love the house of God than your house. Some people love their house more than the house of God. Why is it like that? And that house you love, one day they will remove your body from that house, carry it to the cemetery. You will not go back again. So learn to love the house of God. You hear noise in the church. Ah, what is happening here? Oh, people are just gathered to me. Can I join? No, she said, for others, okay. Make yourself available to do the things of God. We are looking for somebody that will be coming to the church to pray. All of you are putting your hand up because you are here prayer. I will come, even if you are not free, but be coming, be praying. Please make yourself available to fellowship with the brethren. Hallelujah. Bible study, you are there. Evangelism time, you are there. Conference, you are there. Women program, you are there. Night vision, you are there. Chapter meeting, you are there. You are there in everywhere. Daddy Rita is on Zoom preaching to this person. Please give me the Zoom line. I want to join. This is how you will be increasing. You will know more things. Learn to love the word of God. Learn to hear. Love to hear. Don't say, I'm tired. We just came from conference. They are calling again chapter meeting combined. I beg, I'm tired. Don't get tired. Hallelujah. Amen. There is one time like this. I finished preaching in one place. Then all of a sudden again, Daddy was telling me that we have to go somewhere. So I sat in the room. I said, ha, me, I'm tired. We just came with the rest now. The Lord rebuked me. I used one brother in the movement to compare me and the brother work. I say, any child of God that think that this place is a rest will not see my face. This act, my daughter, where you are, is a wrestle ground. You must do all your last strength, any minute, any hour, think of pleasing God. Don't say you are tired, you want to rest. What is the rest? Sleep. If you sleep now, you did not wake up and you did not finish your assignment and go and meet me. Which one is dangerous? That you die doing the assignment and go and rest in heaven. Heaven is the resting place. So go and remove that thought in your mind that I am tired. I am tired. Go and pray. I am tired. Go for night vision. I'm tired. Sister, it's your turn to go and preach. I beg, I tired. I need to rest. Every day you are tired. You are tired. You are pushing the assignment of God. I beg, I tired. Remove that thing. It's Satan. It's a spell. It's a demonized statement. Begin to bind that tiredness, new spirit of tiredness. I destroy in my life. I will not get tired. Even if I'm finished preaching now, they say, please come and pray for somebody. God, give me the grace to pray. I say, no, mama. Mama is a sin. That is how it should be doing. We are just coming from conference. They then answer, women should gather again for another prayer. Don't say I'm tired. Say, God, I need the grace to be here. This is how when you die, you go to heaven, your reward, you will say, hey. So all this tireless work I was doing for God with them all. So this is how my reward in heaven was increasing. But you will do a good work. I use mama and water either. Coordinators, if coordinator like calling for prayer or 2 months, you do like meeting. Yeah, I'm not going. Your mouth has scattered your blessing. You go to conference, you pray 4 days, nothing happened to you. Maybe it's this 2 days or this 1 hour prayer coordinated calling is where angel will come with your own. I say, I beg, I just come for conference. I don't get time. I'm tired. All the time prayer. But is it not prayer? We just come for. And this is how your blessing will go. The angel will carry the blessing back. The Bible says we'll pray for every careless word in our mouth. Don't you know? If you know you are tired, you cannot call. Pray for the grace. If you're still tired, take excuse. Don't murmur. Don't criticize. How many of you murmur like this? Now this is a program. There are some of your sisters, you know, they told you, I'm not coming. I'm busy. That day is not good for me. They did not tell us earlier. Excuse. Go and tell them that their spiritual life is dry. They have lost their spirituality before God. They are not born again. They are only carrying the name born again. They are not born again. They are not spirit-filled believers. Hallelujah. So learn it today. Learn it today. Learn to come to the fellowship. Some of you love the world more than coming to the house of God. You love the world. 1 John chapter 2. See what the Bible said here. You love the things of the world more than coming to church. More than doing the things of God. Night vigil. You will not see them. Some people, they hate coming to night vigil because it's night prayer. But if you say party, if you say married, we are dancing, I shall be danced. All throughout the night, we'll dance. You will see them there dancing in the village. Some of you that go to the village, now only God knows what people used to do there before coming. Because since nobody is there to monitor you people, you will go, my sister is getting married. We'll do, I shall be dancing the night for the stroke, morning for the wedding. You will dance. Hey, past three. Hey, the time is not even going. They will bring all this traditional drum. You'll be dancing. But in night vigil, that time you say you like sleeping. Why are you not sleeping now? Why are you not sleeping now? Because it's nightclub, music is playing. But when it's in the church, you give a food. By 3 o'clock, me, my body cannot stand. I've gone to bed. But when they are playing music, your body can absorb till 5 o'clock. And you say you want to go to heaven. These are all record against you. You don't love Jesus. You don't love. See what the Bible says about those that love the things of the world. You love wedding more than coming to church. You cannot cancel wedding for church. You must go every wedding in your family. You must go. Any burial you must attend. Even when they say, sister, we have women conference. No, my auntie that there must be there. You are not serious. 1 John chapter 2, verse 15 says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. You don't hear? Very simple. Jesus, I love you, is my love. Jesus, you love me too much. You are singing it. You don't love Jesus. You cannot forfeit something. You cannot close your shop for program. You cannot say, today I'm not selling. I will close shop 1 week. I'm going for program. You cannot do anything. You cannot forfeit anything for God. You cannot. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, you cannot stop with one attachment, perfume, boyfriend, girlfriend, fornication, drinking, smoking, because you love those things more than God. That is the flesh. And the lust of the eyes, if you like watching pornography, now it's Big Brother. Big Brother Niger, some of you say it's just entertainment, pornographic entertainment, where they are teaching your children how to sex, how to make love. Blues is what they are doing there. And you call yourself Christian. You have a satellite in your house. You are busy watching Big Brother in your house. Even there are some Christian movie now that is not even godly. Hey, you're busy sitting now, watching it 24 hours. Some is in your phone. You spend time on that thing. And when you looked at, you have missed chapter meeting, you are not going. You say, all these things, loss of the eyes, all these things you like. Some of you, they have talked about cloth, but you will not hear because you love some styles. There are some styles are not for born again Christian. You look at it like this, it's good, but no, this one, I cannot wear it. I've passed that level. These ones are for people that are not born again. All these sinners that want to be showing their shape, how they to entice men in the church, how they should walk a man with lust after them. Me, I don't seduce a man. It's God that will bring a man for me, not me seducing a man. So your mind will not be all this naked, tight, fitting dressing, but your eyes are still inside those worldly things. And the pride of life is not of the Father, but of the world. That is what I'm telling you. It's because some of you have the flesh in you. That's why you are still having these thoughts of worldliness. in you. So please take away those things from your life. Love coming to the church, have time with God, like being among brethren, home fellowship, you are there, Bible study, you are there. Tomorrow we have program here. Next tomorrow we have program here. Come and be here. Even if you are going to your church, come and add more to your spiritual man. Come and add, but don't get tired of being in the church. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You can read Galatians chapter 6, verse 7. You will see it there. And now we are going to Christian services and activities. Things that you need to be doing as a Christian, as a Christian. You see, Muslims, there are things, if you ask them, a baby as a small child like this, they will tell the baby to learn to pray. The baby must know how to read Quran at a certain age. They'll start teaching them. This was what they see, that they're already long Quran, because this is what they should do to show that they are followers of Allah. We are followers of Jesus, the Almighty God, the only way, the true way, the I am that I am. There are things you should do as Christians. One, you should love giving. Anybody that don't love giving, you are not a child of God. Some of you have plenty clothes in your house that others don't have, but it is there, pile up, you cannot give. Anyway, you take to me, you say, this one I like it, you put it down again. But you will take it 3 months, you will not wear it. You have shoes. Go and pray and say, God, take away this covetousness in me. Give me the heart of giving. Let me love giving, because it is a sin. Some don't like charity. It's all part of giving. You don't give charity. Even in the church, they will say, please, one of our sister is sick. Our coordinator is not feeling well. Oh, please, one of our sister, our brother house caught fire. We need to gather money. Please, we need to give to the conference that is coming to cook food for people. Some of you will say, I don't have money. Please, we need support. If the church say 1,000, 1,000 exact is what you will give. Some of you have to give more than 20,000. You have enough. God has blessed you. We don't know, but you know God has blessed you. You have way God is blessing you. But because if the church is 1,000, but you know, sister, you have. God has blessed you. In fact, God is blessing your business. You can give more than 1,000. Close your eyes and say, I give 10,000. I give 20. Not pride. Not to say, they will tell I'm showing off. No, you love giving. You love doing charity. Oh, that sister don't have cloth. Please, okay, I will know what to do. Go to your house, pack your cloth. Even new ones. Don't say, I don't wear this way. You are not a good giver. Pack even the one you love. Sacrifice it. As it's paying you, it's a sacrifice. Hallelujah. You do like this. Bring in ideas. Learn to give good ideas to the church. Hallelujah. When they are asking, what are we going to do to develop this church, to develop the movement, to help people, learn to give ideas. Don't sit down. Don't say, if I talk now, they will not hear. No, speak it out. Learn to give good ideas to the house of God. Sometimes walk up to the women leader, walk up to coordinator, walk up to unit leader, even to your sister. Say, sister, come. I heard you are asking about social counseling. I can tell you, this was what is happening. Go and try this. Some of you, your sister have bad odor, but you know how to criticize. Many, she's coming up. And you know the solution. To use alum, to use life, other things. You cannot call and give good ideas, good counsel. But your own is to mock people. It's a bad attitude. Don't do that. You are waiting for the coordinator to fall. Women leader to do error. You have the idea. This thing that mommy is doing like this is not good. I have the idea. If we do like this, it will come out well. Go and meet her. Pastor, this way you used to carry us like this is not good. But if we use, let's try this way again. Learn to give good ideas. Hallelujah. These are the spiritual things you will do as a child of God, that God will add more to you. Don't hide your gift. Visitation. Visitation is part of services in the house of God. Part of the activities you should be committing yourself to do. Only one sister that good in visiting people. Only one brother like visiting somebody. Don't do like that. Join it. You know how to visit people. Learn to go. Don't say, if I go now, they'll say, I'm a gospel. Stop thinking evil thoughts. Evil thought is not good. If you know you love visiting, you have that charisma, that wisdom, how to visit. Come to the pastor, say, sir, I've not been seeing brother this for long. Because sometimes the coordinator will not take notice that our sisters are not coming. But I want to visit that sister. It will be good if we go there. We need to carry this. Please. They will say, ah, sister, this idea you brought is good. Okay, let's go. Bring good things. Learn to visit one another. Pay your transport to visit somebody. This person is staying far. I cannot go, but it's a burden to me. I'm not saying the bed. Use that your 500 naira just to go and recover that soul. Do you know how much God will give you in heaven? A mansion that even if you have 100,000 on earth or 1 million naira, it will not be that kind of reward. To give you that kind of reward. So learn to do visitation. Visit people. Evangelism is part of a service rendered to God. Always like coming for evangelism. Don't say, this thing is not evangelism is not fruitful. Come on, it will be fruitful one day in Jesus' name. Prayer for the brethren. Always learn to intercede for your brethren. For some of you, start praying now. When they say, let us pray for Nigeria. Father, we want to thank you for that. Let's pray for coordinator. Father, we want to thank you for that. Let's pray for this. But let's pray against any demon that say you will not marry. Somebody is Catholic. I am ready to kill Satan now. He has come to my own turn. You must die. 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 That time, you know that sister can sweat in prayer. But now when they were saying pray for other person, she was just standing there. Father, we want to thank you for this sister. Oh, God. Oh, yeah, let pray any demon that say you will not progress. You will not make heaven. Sister, shift to Abel. Shift. Shift. That is selfishness. We should not do that. We should always learn. When they say somebody is sick, please, we need to visit that person in the hospital. Please, we need prayer intercession. The movement, so we need people to come and be interceding for the movement. Always make yourself available. Don't say, well, we go there and other people they will be praying for. Me, I'm tired of praying for this governor. I'm tired of praying for this senator. I'm tired of praying for the director, mommy leader. They will not pray for us. Don't get tired. The Bible says, he that water shall be what? So when you keep on praying for other people, even if you do not put your mouth for your own program, your own progress, God will bless you. Say, he's an intercessor. Look at her. Look at his own problem. Look at her own problem. But he's busy facing this church problem. God, Jesus will intercede and say, my father, bless her. Surprise her with her gifts. Surprise her with something that she never think of. That is it. So don't be a selfish Christian. It's only your own prayer point you can pray fiery. But when they say, pray for that sister backslide. You say, hey, why we pray for ourselves? We are telling you, you know, you are not got time to pray for you. Are not born again. Don't be thinking about that in Jesus' name. So we should stop with them. The lastly, leadership correction. Leadership correction, advice, and supervision. We turn to Hebrews chapter 13. Hebrews chapter 13. Quickly, I'm running up now. Our time is gone. Hebrews chapter 13. 13 verse 17. It says, obey them that have the rule over you and submit yourself, for they watch for your souls as they that must give account, that they may do it with joy and not with grief, for that is unprofitable for you. Learn to obey your leaders, because tomorrow you too will be a leader. Hallelujah. Learn to obey your leader. Don't put age before. I told somebody, I said some people in this movement, they use age to treat me. You say not this small girl, who will call her mommy, who will greet her. I just look at her and laugh at things because they don't know God. Is it me that puts myself here? Is it not God? So if you love God and you respect God and you fear God, anybody that God put as a leader, even if the person have error, don't disrespect that person. Coordinator is calling me to go there. Coordinator is talking rubbish. When he finish, find time to correct him. Coordinator says we should do it. It's hard. Obey and do. Women leader is calling. Don't see this woman. She not get time. Only tell the couple small lady. Now they call us for meeting. Me not get time. Don't do like that. Because God will test you. Time will come. You too. They will make you leader. And you want women to submit to you. They will not submit. You will not say, because it's my turn now. You people are not coming for meeting. But when I call meeting, God will remind you that you, were you going for meeting for that other woman leader? So learn to obey your leader. Learn to obey your leader. Be a small leader, big leader. Leader is a leader. Choir leader is saying, keep quiet. Don't say, I know how to sing more than this person. We are none of that. Your talent will make a way for you. Your submission will make a way for you. God will promote you. Don't promote yourself. Don't say, this leader is not qualified to teach me. You don't even know the Bible. I know more than that. You just keep quiet. Be praying, God, please teach our leader. Oh, look at me here. I can do it more. It's God that will bring you up. Don't disrespect the leader. Why are you talking to your leader? Is he born again? Did he know how to preach? May I know how to preach? I'm not. You are not qualified. You are not part of the body of Christ. Disobedience. So please, please don't bring flesh into the work of God. Don't allow flesh to rule your spiritual life. Hallelujah. Obey your leaders. Obey their word. Talk to them. Tell them. Come for fellowship. As we are saying, talk to your leaders. Correct them. Don't fear them in the sense of fear, but respect them. Talk with them with respect. A coordinator is calling you, what you did is bad. The coordinator is talking, you are talking. The unit leader is talking, you are talking. It's looking somehow. Women leader is talking, you are talking. It's no, keep quiet. When they finish, say, mommy, sorry. It was done like that, ma. Rest up the fear in you. As long as they say, this is a leader. Even if it's a small brother, they are put there. Or a young sister. Or a sister that is not married, but they say it's a unit women leader. Obey her. So that you too, God will make you to be obeyed. They will obey you tomorrow. Hallelujah. You can read Hebrews chapter 12, verse 5 to 11, because there is no time. Philippians chapter 2, verse 19 to 23. You will see how they will guide you there, how to obey a leader. Leadership correction. When the leader corrects you, take it. Don't argue it. When the leader disciplines somebody, stand with the church. The church have said this person to be disciplined. This person don't go corner and begin to say, me, I'm not with them, all. I'm with you. You are enemy of the church. You are enemy of God. A leader have said this person has behaved rudely. He should leave. And you go and pass there and say, I'm with you. Don't mind that leader. Oh, you are the one tearing the body of Christ. It's evil. When Judas called, we did not see any sign in the Bible that the disciples, they were mourning him. They even went to him. Everybody was on their own, doing their prayer, waiting for the Holy Ghost, the Pentecost to come upon them. Because Judas, you were there when Jesus was talking, somebody among us, Jesus. You did not see any sign in the Bible that the disciples mourned. Peter went in the corner and went, maybe Judas, why do you do that now? What is it? You people are playing with Christianity. They discipline your sister. Rebuke your sister. You say, it's my sister. You pass in the corner and begin to pamper and sin. And you are defiling the word of God. You are breaking the law. You don't know what is Christianity. That's why you are playing like that. The Christianity, that's what the Bible calls us soldiers. You can, if now you are two brothers. One is a military army in Nigeria army. And the other one is in Boko Haram. When they go to fight, you there's no brother there. No brother. There's no brother in the army. As long as you have been in the enemy side, brother, I will clear you. That is what will happen after the rapture. When the mark of the beast will be given to people, those that will not rapture, as soon as you take the mark of the beast, you will hate anything called Christ. Any Christian that don't have the mark, in fact, you'll be the one to be pointing. They are here. They are here. They are here. You become antichrist, enemy of Christ. Anybody that is Christian, you go and be pointing. As immediately you take that mark on your forehead or your hand, your brain, the spirit of Satan will enter you. You will be changed. Your husband that did not rapture, but he's hiding for his life. You will be the one that will go and say, he's here. He's here. He did not take the mark. He's a follower of Christ. You become so angry with anything called Jesus, anything. So please, please obey your leaders. Hallelujah. Obey those ones that have rule over you. Because the way your leader is praying for the church, like my husband, daddy intercede. He will pray for coordinator. That was some of the time I said, you love coordinator so much. He intercede for the church. If person send me message, oh, daddy phone is too far on. Sometimes I put it off for him to rest. Midnight, you know, different places in the country. Some people, while we are sleeping, America, they're off. So some people don't want to know the time of Nigeria, they will just call because they are in trouble. 4 o'clock morning, 2 in the morning, 1 in the morning, daddy phone, you will get up. Hello? He said, oh, daddy, sorry to wake up. No, go ahead. I say, wonderful, more grace. Go ahead. You will be listening like this. Daddy, I need prayer. Please, cover your head. Sometimes when it is serious, you will get up. You will see daddy will be telling you, look for something to chew. Tell them you are tired. Let the person go, this is my work. Give me something to chew. To chew, so the air will be clear. Literally, yes, I'm here, I'm here. Two, 3, 12, 1. Now, as I'm talking, we are going to run. He's going to talk with youth. He's doing it so that he will not have any accuse. But you, is that man now that the leader will say, stop this. You will talk against him. You will insult him when he's busy praying. Now, some of you don't know that. That is intercede for all the more members. Intercede for them, their spiritual life. Let's pray for this chapter. Let's pray for this coordinator. Let's pray for all the more worldwide. Let's pray for the women. Let's pray for the men. Let's pray for the youth. We pray. So if you don't know, and this man always is correcting you, go insulting. Go with judge the God. He has been interceding for you. He loves you, but you don't know. So don't disrespect your leaders. If God did not send you to rebuke a leader, don't rebuke them. Me here, Sister Linda, people say, I'm talking against pastor. If it's not God that said, expose their sin, what I show you say, I will not say it because they are pastor. But the only person that have the right to rebuke them, who is the supreme leader? Who is he? Jesus. So if Jesus said, talk, you talk. The other one, nobody have the power to stop you. No man. Hallelujah. So please, if God did not say rebuke a leader, if God did not say do this, if you are not led to do it well, please, even if you are correcting them as a brother, as a son, do it in love. Don't castigate them. Don't hate them. Even if a coordinator, a pastor, or a brother is a sinner, do it in love. Don't disrespect them because they are leaders. It's God that will judge them. But if Jesus told you to say it, and Jesus will tell you how you should do it, sometimes Jesus will say, go and meet him. Sometimes Jesus will say it openly. Nobody has the power to touch you. But you, because of pride, I will talk to him. And he's not a sinful leader. I will tell him anything. Some of you, because of anger, the leader corrects you. Now go and gather other people who insult them, who bring down remorse. You are not born again. And you, don't join those kind of clique. Those groups, don't join them. Because you are just wasting your Christian life. Stay alone. The Bible says salvation is personal. You will die and stand before God. Even if you die today with your husband, or with your church member, when you are rising up, leaving your body, you go alone. And when they are judging you, they don't judge you in group. They judge you one after another. So know the group you will join. Know the kind of people you join. Some of you, your friends in the church, they are the ones that have killed your spiritual life because they don't pray. They don't love coming to chapter meeting. Their mind is making money. Making money. Hey, making money. So you two, things of God now, is all making money. They'll be giving you bad counseling. Separate from those kind of friends that are not giving you good counsel in the things of God. Look for people that love the things of God so that as you follow them, they like prayer. Ah, this is a life prayer. This is all the time you come for chapter meeting. This is always in evangelism. These are the people you love. Pray and say, God, is he a genuine sister? If the Lord say yes, join her, learn from her. Don't be proud. Love, sister, I like your dressing. I like your commitment. I like the way you praise God. So this is how you grow. So please, as we end now, I end with worldly dressing. You can read Revelation chapter 22 from verse 12 to 17. All these things we are talking, nobody that put on earring, naked dressing, even holy Christians, that your dressing is incomplete. Your skirt is on top of your knee. Your skirt is tight. When you bend down, we have told you about open neck. When you bend down like this, somebody see your breast. Pastor, welcome. Oh, daddy, welcome. We are seeing your breast. You think you are dressing holy. Go and raise up your blouse neck. Give it freedom. Give your hand long sleeve. Make it open. We are not dressing to attract anybody. God is the one that beautifies us. You see holy sister getting good husband that even those in the world, they cannot get. Those in the world, their husband is cheating on them, beating them, lying to them. But most of our sisters that are holy, right, or their husband, love them. They don't cheat on them. They don't have stress to say, I'm dragging a girl with my husband. Your husband loves them. What sinners are looking for in a man, they cannot get. God is giving the only child of God that man. So why you need to go and seduce a man? Be holy. Dress holy. Boys, they are looking for a woman that will obey them, respect them, love them. Ask some of our brethren here, their wife, when they talk, yes, sir, yes, daddy. Small brother like this, the wife is obeying him. But go and look in the sinner's marriage. You see the wife calling the husband, slapping the husband, divorcing the husband, insulting the husband. Why? They are not born again. So all you need, come to Christ, be holy, be full in Christ. Let your spiritual life grow with the word, with prayer, with supplication, everything. Then you will make heaven. Let's be on our feet and say, God, recover my spiritual life. begin to tell the Lord, Satan has made me to hate coming to the church, make me to see the messages is too long to sit down to listen, make me not to love prayer, I cannot pray for long. God, recover my spiritual life, recover my spirituality in Christ, recover my prayer life, recover
sisters,
my prayer
God bless you all. It is time to pray as our mom is praying. We are going to pray with her by the grace of God. Will you open your mouth as she did the prayer point in the name of Jesus?
Amen.
Jesus Christ, my God. Fasting. Some people don't love fasting. Wait, some people say I have ulcer. It is not true. Learn to fast. These are all things that build up the spiritual life. Begin to tell the Lord, Lord, make me to love God. Make me to love the word of God. To pray. Make me to love you. Make me to love the Bible.
Recover my spirituality in Christ, O Lord. Father, have mercy upon my soul, Lord. Recover my spirituality. Help me to love me. Help me to love my story, Lord. Father, Lord, we find our spirit, Lord. This is my spiritual life, God. Father, God, from spiritual life. Lord, have mercy on me. We are going to be spiritually cold. Father, have mercy on me.
Wet our spiritual life. You that your life has gone dry, you can't pray, you can't fast, you don't like coming to church again, you don't even read the books in all the month. Some of you don't have time to read, you fear the book. Some of you don't listen to CDs like that. You are going to say, Father, see my hands up, have mercy upon me and repay me. Give me the grace to start doing my Christian life. Services. As a Christian, I'm supposed to know your word. I'm supposed to study the word of God like I'm studying for exam. I'm supposed to know scriptures off air. I'm supposed to be a prayerful person. I'm supposed to pray for the sick to be healed. I'm supposed to pray for my life to be changed. I'm supposed to fast. I'm supposed to see vision, have discerning spirit. But because I cannot pray, I'm supposed to love the house of God. They are going to a party, marriage, job, all the time we are looking for money. I don't go regularly for Bible study, regularly for prayer meeting, night vigil. Father, wet me, oh God. Give me the grace. Give me the grace. Recover me every power. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
You are going to pray every spell that the devil has released upon you. Any chain of the devil that has held you not to grow spiritually, that chain of dryness, chain of sleep, chain of weakness, let that chain be broken over your life. Let the Lord recover you out of that spell. In the name of Jesus, begin to tell the Lord, Lord, take away sleepiness for me. Every sleep, that power of sleep. Anytime they say prayer, I will sleep. I find that demon of sleep.
My grave, whatever sickness that the devil is inflicting in my life to hinder my spiritual life, the blood of Jesus destroy every headache, every migraine. Go destroy for me tiredness, tumulty. Deliver me, destroy all those sicknesses for my body. In the mighty name of Jesus, every arrow fired against me to destroy my spiritual life, I say be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Every chain that the enemy has used to hold me down, let that chain break in the name name of Jesus. Father, deliver me, Lord. Cover my spiritual life. Cover my spiritual life. Recover my spiritual life. Recover my spiritual life. Recover my spiritual life, oh God. In the name of Jesus.
Monitoring me, oppressing me. You know when something is oppressing you, you want to come up. You want to start praying. You want to start fasting. You want to start listening to a message. You want to start doing devotion. You want to start doing something. But there is a step pressing you that you say, oh, I've started again. You are going to say, any demon, assigned agent that have been released against you and your family to dry up your spiritual life. Let that power of heaven fall upon that demon. Let that satanic hand, that witch and wizard, I want to be like Mary. You are the same God yesterday, today, and forever. You are the God that used them. You are the God that used them and guide them in their life till they make heaven. You guided Moses, Peter, Paul, till they make heaven. God, you are still that same God. Lord, I pray, use me, guide me, protect me, help me to be sober, help me to be vigilant, help me to be fervent, help me to be a true Christian. God, help me, intercede for me, Jesus. Begin to tell the Lord to use you. Tell the Lord to help you.
Help my spiritual life. Help me, holy Father, show me my love. I want to be like help me in the word of God. Father, help me, help me, help me, help my health. Jesus, deliver me from all the sicknesses. Deliver my body from all the struggles, God. Deliver my health, oh God. Father, you shed me. God, have mercy on my soul. Help me, my Christian life. Help me to love the word of God. Father, he said, let the word of God dwell in me. Help me to keep myself to the word of God.
Thank you for this day. We give you praise, we give you glory. All your children, Lord, that they have lost their Christianity, lost their Christian services, they have gone astray. Lord, they are here today to recover it. Father, give them the grace to recover in Jesus' name. Amen. Lord, make them to be prayerful. Make them to love coming to the fellowship. Make them to start doing the Christian services. Make them to obey their leader. Those that have unforgiveness to one another in the church, that make them not to be coming to the chapter. Father, give them the heart to forgive. Settle their grievances in the name of Jesus, oh Lord. Father, those that the devil has robbed them, they cannot read. They cannot study the word of God. They don't have time. They are too busy. Satan have kept them with busy life, looking for money. I destroy this power
in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Every distraction that the devil has released upon them, every sickness that used to comfort, anytime they want to pray, their head will pain them. Anytime they want to fast, altar. Anytime they want to come to church, problem or the other, to take those things, receive fire. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Every chain that have made them to be slave in sin, they want to be born again. They want to be holy. They want to stand and say, I am a child of God. Since I give my life to Christ, I've never lied. I don't fornicate. I don't gossip. I don't compromise. But Lord, anytime they plan to do, the Bible says the things I want to do, I see myself doing it. That is what Paul was saying. Father, give them the grace that they will never sin again. Oh God, at the end, Lord, they will not cry in hell. They will not weep in hell. They will not cry in hell. Satan will not laugh at them. But God, as they said, they are born again. Keep them in this path. Increase their faith. Increase their spiritual life. Make them to be solid. Make them to be strong. Make them to be hot. That no sin will dwell in them. Witches and wizards will not come close to them. Let their life produce fire. Let their life produce fire. Let their spiritual life produce fire. Father, Lord, at the end, they will be able to rapture. They will make heavens. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we cover them with the blood of Jesus. Lord, I pray recover their spiritual life. Give them the grace for them to recover their spirituality.
Amen.
Let them be useful in the heart of God. The things that we are not doing to please you, let them start doing it. Father, forgive them for their sins. Forgive them for all their bad behavior that I've been doing in the church. Father, I pray use this world to bring many souls to God. Let Gariki chapter take a new page. Let the children of God be united. Let them do the work of God. Let them do greater things for you. Break every conviction, backbiting, gossip, hatred among them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Oh Lord, we pray for divine revival. Let them be revived. Let them be revived. Those that have gone, they have been remorse. Holy Spirit, visit them. Recover them, bring them back. To join the team to do exploit for you. Father, you say this time you need radical evangelism. Give them the power to do radical evangelism. Let the chapter grow. Let the zone grow. Let their businesses grow. Let their spiritual life grow. Let their family life grow. Let their faith grow. Let their holiness life grow. Let power come upon them. Let their prayer life grow. Anywhere they go, people know they are children of God. Father, bless them abundantly as they obey to do their spiritual life, to do the righteousness of God. Father, give them grace. Cover them, bless them, empower them. Father, we thank you. As they have come here, Lord, they will not go astray. Their name will be written in the book of life. And at the end, oh Lord, all of them will see ourselves in heaven. We thank you for this time. We give you praise, we give you all the glory. For in Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, mighty Jehovah. Amen. God bless you all. By the special grace of God, this Friday is our night prayer. So we have time to pray based on this topic that we have listened to, based on this message. We are going to be praying this Friday because we didn't have much time to pray right now. We just put our mother in the Lord, but we are going to really pray on Friday. Our night prayer is 10:30 by the grace of God, start 10:30. So I encourage every one of you, this is the time to pray. This is not the time to look at time, because the time we are in, we need prayer. Like we just hear from our mommy, the Lord, we need prayer. We really need prayer. So I'm encouraging every one of us, for us to be spiritual giants, for us to be powerful women, we must sacrifice. So this is the time for great sacrifice to pray. By the special grace of God, it shall be great on Friday in the name of Jesus Christ. So at this time, I'm going to round up. Amen. God bless you all.
Excuse me, Sister Joy.
Patient. Amen. Yes, go ahead.
Okay, thank you. I just want to announce Sister Charity's team, you will be praying this Thursday. Hallelujah. So Sister Charity will text you all the time for your chain prayer this Thursday in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, Sister.
Amen.
Joy.
Amen. God bless you all. Amen. So it is time to close the prayer. Amen. So before we close the prayer, I just want us to open to the book of Numbers. Numbers 6, verse 24. And hallelujah. Amen. So when we come to the presence of God, we don't go back the same way. God always bless us. Amen. So it's time for us to receive our blessings from the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Number six. Hallelujah. Amen. Please turn your Bibles with me to number 6, 24 to 26. I'm going to read. Amen. Okay, 24, amen. So as I read, it's a prayer, so just receive it by faith in the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Number 6, 24. The Lord bless thee and keep thee in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Please unmute your mic and answer in Jesus' name, amen. Verse 25. The Lord make his face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee in Jesus' name.
Amen.
27. And then, 26. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and be and give thee peace in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Gracious God, Father, we thank you, Lord, for your divine blessing that you have blessed us tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we are about to leave. We are not leaving your presence. We ask your presence to continue to be with us in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for what you have done today. You are helping us to recover our spirituality in Christ, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father, for what you have done. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. In Jesus' name, we have prayed with thanksgiving. Amen. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together with love that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together in love. Jesus, bind us together, Lord. Bind us together with love that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together in love. One more time, bind us together, bind us together, and we'll be broken. Bind us together, bind us together, bind us together. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God,
the Lord,
the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the